Hello, viewing several. You know, there were once two snowmen who stood together in a field. After a little while, one turned to the other and said, "Can you smell carrot?" "Well, tis the season, so I thought I'd start things off with a seasonal joke." I laughed for like 2 minutes the first time I heard that, honestly. Ooh, speaking of season, cue the thing.
I'm 37.
What?
I'm 37, I'm not old.
So yeah, today we are finally getting round to the deluxe tracks from Sixth Season by Noah Kahan. If you've seen the original reaction, which I hope you have, you'll know that I was bowled away by that album. I mean, lyrically, musically, aesthetically, everything about it was just wonderful. Genuinely wished that I'd gotten onto it sooner. And I probably should have listened to the deluxe tracks at the time, but again, if you're a regular enough viewer, you know I tend to go with the original release first, and then if I get a real feel for it, I decide if I want to bother listening to the extra 5, 10, however many more tracks there are. So that's what I'm going to do today, listen to the deluxe tracks. I hope it'll be as good, if not better. I see no reason why it won't, so let's just get into it. The deluxe tracks from Sixth Season. Okay, first track on this here deluxe version, Your Needs, My Needs.
Oh well, who is I? Who is I to watch you? You were a work of art. That's the hardest part. How been like dogs in the light of the moon, holding our breath after 1:32. You asked me why I wasn't saying a word. I'm naming the stars in the sky. It's a work of art. That's the hardest part. Spiral out, try and fold. See a friend, see a ghost. Bitter brained, always drunk. Rail thin, so long.
Oh, Jesus. I'm just going to listen to the deluxe versions from now on. I'm an idiot. I'm a moron. I'm a fool. I hold my hands up. Sorry. Actually had the heating on for a while and a jumper was just too much. Yeah, Christ, everything was on display there. We had the soft lilting tones that he does so well, the little plinky plonky guitar, and then we got the twang in the chorus, and then it opened up, and then it opened up more. You know, the fact that he got into belting, which I don't think I heard on the original, you know, release version, like a real wail. Ooh, that was a wonderful start. Okay. Yeah, okay. Going forward, deluxe versions. I understand. Sorry. Yes, sorry. So, next track. Dial Drunk.
I'm remembering, I promise to forget you now. It's raining and I'm calling drunk.
Do you not hear enough of that there banjo nowadays? So I ain't taking any fall. Am I honest still? Am I half the man I used to be? I doubt it, forget about it, whatever. So the same anyways. I ain't proud of all the punches that I've thrown in the name of someone I no longer know. For the shame of being young, drunk and alone. Traffic lights and the transmitter radio. I don't like the when they threw me in the car. I gave your name as my emergency phone call on the air. Ring and ring, even the cops thought you were wrong for hanging up. I dialed drunk, I dialed drunk, I'd die for you. I'm untethering from the parts of me you'd recognize. Charming the poetry.
I'll be buried and I'll let the pain metastasize. But that's morning, I'll forget it. And the dial tone is all I have.
That lead up. Sing along. I'm not on board with the melody 100%. Also, I can't sing.
My faith, I'll kiss the fast. Wait, I swear she'll call me back. Son, why do you do this to yourself? And I said, I ain't proud of all the punches that I've thrown in the name of someone I don't know. For the shame of being young, drunk, alone. Traffic lights in the transmitter radio. I die drunk, I die drunk, I die for you.
Hot damn. Jeezy H.E. Christie. It's just so good. The arrangement, like the musical arrangements, the instrumentation, all of that is beautiful. His voice remains sublime. The storytelling, it's all there. And again, more of my embarrassing trademark chair dancing. It is what it is. I can't help it. This is stirring me. Yes. Enough chatter. Continue. Next track. Paul Revere.
Counting light, I'm counting down. Mailboxes until my house. This place had a heartbeat in its day. Veil bought the mountains and nothing was the same. One day I'm gonna cut it clear. Ride like Paul Revere and when they ask me who I am, I'll say I'm not around here. I'll leave before the road crews out,
for those joggers looking way too proud. And I'll turn up the music and I'll forget until it ends that I'm not ready to let go yet. It's typical, I fear. Folks just disappearing when they ask me who I am.
Oh, that false sense.
I say I'm not from around here.
Oh, yes, bring in the mournful strings. Why not?
I see the yard, the patch of grass where we buried the doll. And the world makes sense behind the chain link fence. If I could leave, I would have already left.
Again, superb storytelling when he does the falsetto thing. I always look forward to that in any track. Yes, onwards. Very apt title. No complaints.
Thought I had something, and that's the same as having something. I get mad at nothing, blame my dad for something. I pull no punches, then feel bad for months. Thought I was raised better, tried to fake better, tried to blame weather and escape better. Hope the skin heals where the pain enters. But I finally got showed up. I said it's time, then I showed up. Now the weight of the world ain't so bad. I saw the end, it looks just like the middle. Got a paper and pen in a page with no space. I filled the hole in my head with prescription medication and forgot how to cry.
Said enough, the lyrics. Come on.
Now the weight of the world ain't that bad. I saw the end and looked just like the middle. Got a paper and pen and a page with no space. I filled the hole in my head with prescription medication and forgot how to cry. Fill the hole in my head with prescription medication and forgot how to cry. Who am I to complain?
Like the way he addresses mental health, and there's a lot of sentiments that have come up at various points in the album that I can definitely... not just on these tracks, on the previous ones too, that I can definitely relate to. Even just that phrase, just, you know, that common phrase of who am I to complain. I have had lots of periods in my life where I have complained a lot, where I've been... I hesitate to use the word depressed because it feels that that's a clinical term and I don't think it quite qualifies as that, but it's... I'm doing pretty well considering, actually. Not crazy about my job, but my family, my home. But still, there are, you know, moments where you complain about everything that's silly, immaterial, right through to stuff where you literally just wonder what the point of it is. Anyway, I'm rambling. On to track 5. Next track, Call Your Mom. You're not coming home tonight.
Oh, you spy, but then again, the moment right before it ends, you're most afraid of. Don't you cancel any plans? 'Cause I won't let you get the chance. You never make them. Stayed on the line with you the entire night till you let it out and let it in. Don't let this darkness fool you. All lights turned off can be turned on. I'll drive all night. I'll call your mom. Oh dear, don't be discouraged. I've been exactly where you are. I'll drive all night. I'll call your mom. I'll call your mom.
Oh, getting a lot more of that beautiful falsetto and a really sad song.
Greatest fears and ringing hands in the loudest silence. If you could see yourself like this, if you could see yourself like this, you'd have never tried it. Stayed on the line with you the entire night till you told me that you had to go.
Okay, feel like a bit of an asshole for making that joke that I made beforehand. Okay, that's, you know, poignant to say the least. Very important subject matter. Yeah, there's a lot to relate to in this album. Yeah, that's so. I've not had to deal with that personally, in the sense of having to console or be that for someone else. You know, other people have kind of had to do that with me now and then. Just again, the poetry of it, the lyric, then, you know, don't let the darkness fool you. The lights can be turned on. It's just, it's a very important message, and it's very sad. But it, yeah, it's necessary. It's important. It's something that, when it's conveyed in great art, hopefully it takes some of the stigma and some of the you know, the bullshit that can surround that subject. I'm rambling again. Right, come on, man. Next track, You're Gonna Go Far.
Time I got to praying for a red light, when I saw your destination as a deadline. It's just normal conversation, babe, it's all fine. Making quiet calculations where the fault lies. It's as good a land, or at least it was. It takes a strong hand and a sound mind. It makes me smile to know when things get hard. Ooh, you'll be far. Ooh, you'll be far from here. And while I clean shit up in the yard, ooh, you'll be far, ooh, you'll be far, far from here. So pack up your car, put a hand in your heart, say whatever you feel, be wherever you are. We ain't angry at you, love. You're the greatest thing we've lost. The birds are still sing, folks are still fight, the forge are still creak. Still die, we ain't angry at you, love. We'll be waiting for you, love. And we'll all be here forever. That's the thing about survival. Who the hell likes living just to die? Oh, we ain't angry at you, love. You're the greatest thing we've lost. Birds are still singing. Still fight the board, still creep the leaves, still die. We ain't angry at you, love. We'll be waiting for you, love. You're gonna go far. You're gonna go far. If you wanna go far, then you gotta go.
The message of that one was really bittersweet, almost the definition of it. Because the sentiment that I think I was picking up, at least, is, again, with that line that I referred to, you know, we're angry at you. I'm not going to get all choked up. Yeah, we ain't angry at you. You know, you're the greatest thing we've ever lost. Which is a sentiment that I hold for my own kids. I really hate the idea of them ever sticking around longer than they need to. I want them to go out into the world. I want them to experience things. I want them to find their own footing. As portrayed in that line, and the overall sentiment of the song, I feel like it's saying, go, be who you want to be, and for God's sake, get out of this town, get out of this setting. Don't be stifled. Don't be like us, because we're going to be here forever. Which to me sounds like they're saying we're always going to be here for you, but also unfortunately that means we're going to be here forever. We're not going anywhere. We're not doing anything else. So yeah, definition of bittersweet. This album, man. Okay, let's close it out with an extended version of the closer from the original release, The View Between Villages.
Air in my lungs till the road begins, and I'm split in the road.
I hope you'll forgive me, but I really just want to sort of sit back and take this in.
For a feel the rush of my blood, I'm 17 again. It's just me in the curve of the valley, and there is meaning on earth. I am happy. Out to Brook Road, I'm over the bridge, a minute from home, but I feel so far from it. Cars in reverse, I'm gripping the wheel, I'm back between villages, and everything's still.
Well, I, for me personally, I found the town big enough for anything that I want. I mean, I'm not a city girl by any means.
Trafford still has a lot of meaning to me because I grew up there. Well, I guess it's a small community of people that really look out for each other. And that's the same way with anybody that needs anything. It's this community is there to help. And everything still.
Yeah, that extended version did not disappoint. Okay. Yeah, obviously it was going to be an experience. I knew I was going to love it, but one thing that's definitely cemented for me is listen to the deluxe version of the albums. Listen to the special edition, the whatever. Listen to the extra tracks. Yeah, it'll mean a longer recording session, more time editing, blah, blah, blah. Doesn't matter. Do it. Because those tracks were fantastic. Not a dud amongst them. That version of The View Between Villages. You know, I don't know. I probably will look it up. If the voices recorded there were one, you know, people that he knows. Parents or whatever. But the sentiment of that closing track has more hope in it and more just sort of, it's still got, well, the inherent bleakness of the album. Let's not pretend it's a happy album. But there are moments of, hope. There are moments of reflection and reminiscing and expectations of the future. And yeah, that closer was, because of those extra elements, was stronger. Yeah. I wish I had more interesting and insightful things to say other than I love this album. Those tracks are wonderful. I wish I'd listened to them the first time round. I'm not going to list standouts because they were all standout. I need to listen to more from him. So any other work that he's put out, any versions of tracks that I would have already heard, just please leave me the suggestions. And again, any suggestions or ideas about similar artists that you think I should listen to, I'm always happy to hear that. So yeah, I guess I'll close by just saying that I'll be back on the Tay train very soon with a very long session, which will have to be split into two parts because there's quite a lot of tracks on this particular Taylor's version. Oh, I wonder what it could be. Thank you, as always, to the new subscribers, to the return viewers, to anybody who's given this channel any degree of support. It does mean a lot. I know I say a lot. I know that I'm not particularly coherent a lot of the time. I know there are better people on this platform who probably give more insight or whatever. So I am appreciative of anybody who spends the time to, you know, share this stuff with me. So thank you. Comment, like, subscribe, and goodbye forever.
Now we see the violence inherent in the system. Shut up! Come and see the violence inherent in the system. Help! Help! I'm being repressed.
Bloody peasant!